since you are under the structural organization of Iwahig, dapat doon ka mapabalik sa Iwahig.
Verbal. Yes po.
Yun ang sinasabi ko, Angie, mag-iingat ka sa mga sinasabi. Kung pag verbal yan, wala yan. Wala yung verbal na yan. Kaya kung sinasabi mo na confidential assistant ka right now, wala yun.
Sino ang head ng kwan? Board na nag-kwan sa kanya?
National Selection Board.
Sino ang head nun?
At that time, Your Honor, it was Brigadier General Aro.
Are you aware that General Aro and Madam Bautista are related?
It was later that
no,
I...
No, sagutin mo.
No, Your Honor. No, Your Honor, Mr. Chair.
You do not know?
No,
that they are in loss?
Ano po yung ginagawa ngayon ni Ms. Bautista? Anong function mo ngayon sa Bucor?
Yes, Ma'am Chair, Your Honors, mga member po ng committee, nagparilib po ako for an open investigation. So, kahit hawak ko po yung Executive Assistant for, nagre-report lang po ako sa Office of the Deputy Director for Administration.
So, officially, you are not suspended pending investigation?
Hindi po, sir. Ay, hindi po, ma'am.
So,
nagpa-relieve
po. Who's now your immediate superior?
The DDGA po.
Under the civil service, unless proven guilty, she will remain as Administrative Officer 5. Hindi na siya designated in sa HEA, sa DDGO, saka yung sa superintendent ng NBP. Doon siya na-relieve. But doon sa position niya bilang siya ay Administrative Officer 5, that is subject to civil service.
Yes,
decision.
But what is she actually doing now?
Hindi, ako ang aking pananaw diyan, since you are under the structural organization of Iwahig, dapat doon ka mapabalik sa Iwahig.
Yeah.
I think General Katapang because she was appointed as Administrative Officer 5 sa structure ng Iwahig. Now that you are not designated to any position anymore, so you have to go back to your original mother colony. And that is the Iwahig. Sige, Superintendent Angie.
Mr. Chair, members of the committee, hindi po ako appointed po as Administrative Officer 5. Nag-resign po ako way back po May 15, 2020. Now po, ang hawak ko pong position is Head Executive Assistant 4.
O di co-terminus ka. Kung hindi ka na permanent position at Administrative Officer 5, nag-resign ka mismo sa position yon, the more na hindi ka pwedeng i-appoint dahil co-terminus ka. Mr. Na position right now.
Mr. Chair, plantilla appointment po yung HEA 4. Salary grade 22 po.
Permanent position? Ang executive assistant?
Yes, sir. Head executive assistant for po yung plantilla ko, sir.
Wait. I think we need to find out the executive assistant. Ah. Executive assistant are co-terminus.
Pero unless may...
Co-terminus yan, I believe. Oo, kasi ako, I have a lot of executive assistants and they are all co-terminus. Co-terminus ang executive assistant. That is not a permanent position.
Mr. Chair, maybe we can ask the civil service for an answer, a written answer.
Hindi, wala kasi yung civil service. Yeah. We'll be asking the... kasi I've been a mayor, alam ko yan. Lahat ng executive assistants ko, co-terminus.
That's sige, right, yes, sir.
Wait, Angie. Let's ask the personal services. Andiyan ang division ng personal services. They know this better. Sige. Personal services.
Kaya nga, Mr. Chair, we are asking for the organizational structure, no? Para we can review rin the structure in the Bucor.
That's right. Thank you, Congressman Puentebella. But we'll be asking the Division of Personal Services and Human Resource. You should know this, ha? Human Resource.
Mr. Chair, before I turn over the floor to the next speaker, can we ask General Katapang to submit the procedure? What happens when there's an incident like this? that it happens in the Bilibid, what is the procedure? Sinong inform nyo? Anong ginagawa nyo? I'm sure you have that in your operations manual. Can you just submit that in writing? I don't want to discuss that right now, but I am just curious what happens when such incidents happen inside the Bilibid.
We will comply, Mr. Chair, Your Honor, Madam Chair.
Yes.
Yes, I'm asking for the human resource. Sino ba ang human resource division? Head. Napakahirap naman ata na. Sino? Can you kindly raise your hand kung sino ang head? Ma'am, sino po kayo?
Superintendent Elsa Alabado.
Kayo po ang head ng human resource.
Unfortunately po, nasa kolonya po ngayon o nasa probinsya po yung head ng human resource namin. At
you can sit down please, ma'am. So, ano pong position niyo po, ma'am?
Newly designated po as acting director for Directorate for Administration, sir, Your Honor.
Oh, you should know this. Oh, sige po. Head ng executive assistant, Heya.
I have here right now, sir, the appointment copy po for Ma'am Angie as executive.
Is it a permanent position or it is a co-terminus position?
It's a permanent position, sir.
Head executive assistant.
Executive assistant 4, salary grade 22, sir, under permanent position, Office of the Director General.
Okay, sir. So we need to confirm this, ano? We will be inviting the civil service, ano?
Yes, sir.
You make it sure, ah?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So Superintendent Angie, kung ikaw ang head ng executive assistant right now, no? Kailan ka nag-resign bilang administrative officer 5?
May 15, 2020 po, Mr. Chair.
So nag-resign ka bilang administrative officer.
Administrative
Kailan
officer
5. Kailan ka napasok bilang head ng executive assistant?
December po last year po, sir.
December 4. Tapos sabi mo ngayon nagpa-relieve ka.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi siya resign, relieve lang.
Sa position mo, bilang, ako, sir.
Bilang ano?
NBP po as DDGO and Head Executive Assistant.
Okay, so right now, Heya ka pa rin.
Yung pong item ko, sir.
Yeah, item mo, Heya ka pa rin.
Yes, sir. Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so my co-chair is asking, so anong trabaho mo ngayon? So kung naka-relieve ka pero permanent position ka, hindi ka nagtatrabaho pero pinaseseldohan ka ng ating gobyerno, I think that is something that we need to ask the civil service. How can you be relieved on your position which is permanent?
Sir, I am performing counterintelligence work.
Ha?
Counterintelligence work daw ang ginagawa niya.
Are you designated as on that position? No. No. You're not designated on that position.
Yes, sir, but I am under instruction po, Mr. Chair.
Verbally or by documents? By? Chair. Verbal.
Yes po.
Yun ang sinasabi ko, Angie, mag-iingat ka sa mga sinasabi. Pag verbal ka, Tina, pinag-uusapan natin. You were physically designated sa CIW. Pero ang sinasabi mo, you were formally designated ng PSB ng November 11. Magkakaroon tayo ng confusion tungkol doon sa official and verbal. Kung pag-verbal yan, wala yan. Wala yung verbal na yan. Kaya kung sinasabi mo na confidential assistant ka right now, wala yun. So you have to function as Heya. Kung permanent ka, plantilyado ka, magtrabaho ka. Kaya wala ka karapatan na sabihin mo na sinasabi mo kay General Katapang na nagpaparelieve ka sa sarili mo bilang Heya. That's wrong. Okay? Yes, Congressman Pentabella.
Can we ask, bakit po kayo nagpa-relieve na biglang may ganitong insidente? Importante kayo. Ba't kayo nagpa-relieve?
Your Honor, kasi po nung pong last po natin na hearing, para po yung mga allegations po na binabato sa akin ay magkaroon po ng open investigation. Kasi para po maging fair and square. Kasi it seems po na para po kasi akong ako na rin po nalilito eh. Kasi Unang-una po, ang designation ko as NBP superintendent, ginawa ko po kasi hindi po ako on direct na nagbabantay po doon sa mga PDL.
Angie, putulin na kita para hindi ka masyadong malubog. Okay, maybe you are assuming that you will be relieved doon sa posisyon mo sa DDGO at sa superintendent ng NBP. But being a Heya Plantilla, you cannot be relieved on that position because that is permanent.
Nagkaroon
mo ng confusion. I'm sure. Akala mo, marirelieve ka sa lahat ng trabaho mo. That's wrong. Because if it's true that it is a permanent position, you cannot relieve yourself in that position. That is a government position that is permanent and you have to work.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, a congressman ako.
Liwanagin lang po natin. Sabi po niya, nag-resign siya sa kung ano ang pwesto niya para magkaroon ng open and fair investigation. May I ask, who will conduct the investigation?
Mr. Chair, I have designated General Pereiras, who is the DDG for administration, to conduct the investigation and submit the findings within 1 month at the end of 31 August, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Hindi ba siya na-assign sa office ni General Ferreira?
Purposes of investigation.
Hindi nga. Sagutin niyo muna ako, General. Bago
yes,
kayo
Your Honor.
Explain. Yes.
Yes, Your Honor, Mr. Chair.
Hindi po ba?
Yes.
So, she's assigned there?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, so, it's clear to the members of this committee na si General Ferrer will be the one to conduct the investigation. And so far as the allegations against Angie Bautista are concerned. Okay? May I know when that investigation will be finished?
Mr. Chair, Your Honor, it will be August 31 at the end of the month so that we will be able to know immediately.
Thank you. Kasi a while ago, mayroong nagtanong ay nagsasabi, I think it was the chairman of the Committee on Public Order and Safety na Ms. Bautista or Madam Bautista entered the View Corps as a casual. And when was that, Mr. Chair?
According to her, September.
Of what year?
2019.
So in 4 years from casual, naging superintendent at saka naging head ng Correctional Institute for Women. Hindi po ba kayo nagtataka?
You're wondering.
I do not know. Ang bilis from casual to jail superintendent. Tapos naging head pa na Correctional Institute for Women.
She is more than qualified.
Can you explain that, General Katapang?
Mr. Chair, I did not appoint her because it was...
Explain mo nga muna yun kasi ikaw ngayon ang head eh. Or your director for personnel can... answer these questions.
When Ms. Angie Bautista worked with the Bureau Corps, he applied for the job in 2019. Unfortunately, she resigned. Kailan ka nag-resign?
May 15, 2020, sir.
Nag-resign ng May 15, 20?
2020 po, sir. Your Honor.
2020? Oh, sige, tuloy mo, General Katapang. Paano? Nag-resign na. Sige, paano uli nakabalik? Napakagulo eh.
He applied again for a position of Heya when I came in as the new DG.
So, when you came in, General Katapang, civilian na siya kasi resigned eh. And then she applied for the position of Heya. Tama ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair, Your Honor. You're correct, Mr. Chair. Mm-hmm.
Now, did she pass all the requirements to become a Heya?
Yes, Mr. Chair, Your Honor, because he went through the process of being appointed, Mr. Chair.
Yung Juan, ang hindi ko naman Juan, yung mga qualifications and documents. Kau naman, general eh. Alam mo yun eh, sa armed forces, ganyan eh. Sa PNP, ganyan din.
Yes, Mr. Chair, she is qualified for the position, Your Honor.
She's qualified. Ang nakapagtataka, nung pumasok siya sa Bucor noon, casual lang ang binigay sa kanya. Right? And because of the orders given by General Bantag, naging jail superintendent. Tama? Huwag kang magtasa ng kamay. Angie Bautista, I will come to you. Antayin mo yung tanong ko.
Yes, her appointment orders were signed by the previous DG, Your Honor.
Yes. Could you please tell me, doon sa pagpapasa doon sa board, ano ba ang mga schooling ni Miss Angie Bautista aside from yung course na tinapos niya? Alam mo, General Juan eh, noong si General Lacson ang nagde-defend ng budget ng Juan, hindi siya pwedeng lumingon kasi napakahirap yung head ng institution ng PNP na tuwing tatanungin, ililingon-lingon. Your people should do something so that you will not do that. They should be able to provide your information without you looking back. Tama?
Yes, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Yes. Ano po ang, kung nirevisan nyo talaga yung records ni Madam Bautista, ano po yung mga schooling na in-undergo niya? Kasi,
unfortunately, Mr. Chair, they are still looking for the documents. I beg your indulgence, Mr. Chair, Your
yes.
Honor.
I do. And therefore, what conclusion can you take from your statement?
That's part of the.
And what conclusion could we take from your statement? Na hindi nyo na vet properly.
I think he was vetted properly.
Ano nga yung schooling? Sino ang head ng kwan board na nag-kwan sa kanya?
National Selection Board.
Sino ang head nun?
At that time, Your Honor, it was Brigadier General Aro. He was the head of the
Are you aware that General Aro and Madam Bautista are related?
It was later that
no,
I.
Sagutin mo,
no, Your Honor. No, Your Honor, Mr. Chair.
You do not know
no,
that they are Mr. in loss?
No, Mr. Chair.
You don't know that.
Unfortunately, Mr. Chair, Your Honor, I did not know that.
Kasi nagtataka ako, hindi nyo makita kung anong schooling na ginawa ni o pinasukan ni Madam Bautista. Because from being a jail officer one up to her retirement sa BGMP, wala siyang schooling per records of the Bureau of Jail Management and Penology. And that's why she retired. She made an undertaking that she would retire on a certain year. Kasi ayaw niyang mag-schooling. Do you know that?
No, Mr. Chair, Your Honor.
Aba,
point of order, Mr. Chair.
What's the point of order of Digo General?
We do not want Madam Bautista to always shake her head every time a question is being asked.
So the resource speaker, Superintendent Angie, you are reminded not to make any facial gesture, no, on this committee. Otherwise, we will be citing you in contempt.
My apology, Mr. Chair.
Okay, your apology is accepted. Go ahead, Congressman Ako.
So your vetting process was not conducted efficiently, General Katapang.